What if we told you that the key to the Garden of Eden might be found in a gate that was recently unearthed in Jerusalem? Could this old doorway take us to a paradise that only exists in myth? What mysteries are concealed beyond that doorway? Get ready to go on an adventure that is really biblical in scope. Is now finally the time that we've all been looking forward to? The timer for discovering the secrets of the Garden of Eden has been started, and the countdown has already begun. The garden that is called Eden. The gift that God provided to Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden was their first and greatest gift, but it was lost after the original sin. However, it now stands as a symbol of recovered innocence and boundless hope. The Garden of Eden is dedicated to the narrative of Adam and Eve. God created the first man and woman, the progenitors of all humanity, in the Garden of Eden, also known as earthly paradise. The Almighty gave them that magnificent location, as well as all the animals and plants that had inhabited it, as a gift, so that they could enjoy their fruits and live in absolute satisfaction. One of the characteristics of the Garden of Eden is that it is a place of peace and harmony, where all races of animals live together and no flower is poisonous. Adam and Eve can eat its fruit to their heart's content, and as a result, they are immortal and immune to the effects of aging, disease, and death. God has put this incredible tree in the middle of Eden's garden, right next to the tree that provides knowledge of good and evil. The plot of Garden of Eden. Believers and academics alike have been enthralled for ages by the biblical book of Genesis's account of a mythological paradise called the Garden of Eden. In spite of the fact that the story of the Garden of Eden is profoundly ingrained in both religious and cultural traditions, it is essential to keep in mind that it is not considered to be a historical account, but rather a narrative that is symbolic and metaphorical in nature. The biblical account describes the Garden of Eden as a verdant and fruitful paradise that was created by God to serve as a dwelling place for the first humans, Adam and Eve. According to this account, God placed Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. It is represented as a place of perfect harmony and bountiful resources where people lived in a state of innocence and communion with their Creator. This place also had no wars or conflicts. The tale paints a picture of the garden as a picture-perfect haven filled with an abundance of all kinds of trees and fruits, including the tree of life and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. The only rule that applied to Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden was that they were not permitted to consume any of the fruit that came from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, also known as the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Eve, however, gave in to the temptation that was presented to her by the serpent and ate of the fruit that was not permitted. After that, she gave it to Adam, which ultimately resulted in the two of them being kicked out of the Garden of Eden and the beginning of sin, suffering, and mortality in the world. This occurrence, which is referred to as the Fall, provides a key explanation for the origins of human suffering, as well as the necessity for redemption. Even though the Garden of Eden plays an important role in many different religious traditions, it is essential to keep in mind that the way it is portrayed in those traditions is more metaphorical and symbolic than it is in its actual location. The narrative communicates important religious and moral truths about the essence of humanity, free will, and the repercussions of disobeying authority figures. Throughout the course of human history, a number of different interpretations and hypotheses concerning the potential location of the Garden of Eden have surfaced. Some people believe that it could have been found in Mesopotamia, close to the rivers Tigris and Euphrates. However, others propose various locations, and their ideas are frequently affected by the cultural beliefs that are prevalent in the area. It is important to note that no archaeological evidence or conclusive confirmation of the existence of the Garden of Eden as a physical place has been found. This is something that should be taken into consideration. The story of the Garden of Eden is largely understood and appreciated within the context of religious and cultural traditions. This is because the story functions as a narrative that communicates significant spiritual teachings and insights into the nature of the human condition. As a foundation for religious beliefs and theological reflections on the origins of humanity and the nature of our relationship with the divine, the Garden of Eden ultimately remains a symbolic and mythical fabrication. Its purpose is to serve as a platform for these ideas and thoughts. It continues to provoke thought and the investigation of the human search for meaning and purpose in a world that is perplexing and intricate. Where was the Garden of Eden? Prior to their exile from paradise, Adam and Eve called the Garden of Eden their home. It was a place that was perfect in every way. However, the precise location of the Garden of Eden continues to be the subject of conjecture and argument among scholars. Over the course of several centuries, numerous hypotheses and interpretations have been developed in an effort to pinpoint the precise geographical site of the legendary garden. A number of hypotheses locate it in the part of Mesopotamia that is bounded by the rivers Tigris and Euphrates. This part of the world is sometimes referred to as the Fertile Crescent. The ancient civilizations of Sumer, Babylon, and Assyria are said to have originated in this region, which is why it is sometimes called the cradle of civilization. Some others believe that the Garden of Eden existed in a different section of the world, such as in the continent of Africa, more specifically in the region surrounding the Nile River. Due to their extensive agricultural heritage and close proximity to significant rivers, ancient civilizations such as Egypt have been proposed as plausible locations for the lost city of Atlantis. Some readings of biblical passages and ancient maps imply that the Garden of Eden may have been located in the neighborhood of modern-day Iran, more especially in the region surrounding the Persian Gulf. This idea is supported by the fact that the Garden of Eden is depicted on ancient maps. It is essential to keep in mind that the Garden of Eden is not a real location on Earth. Rather, it is a theological and symbolic concept that represents a state of existence that is flawless and harmonious rather than a specific location on the planet. People believe that it was a paradise, a place filled with plenty, where people lived in harmony with nature and had a direct link to the divine. Due to the fact that the Garden of Eden is a legendary and symbolic place, its precise location is still a mystery that defies identification in a clear and concise manner. People and researchers are looking at a variety of historical, geographical, and theological sources in an effort to decipher their mysterious past. The search for its physical whereabouts continues to be the focus of study, discussion, and interpretation. A condition of blissful communion with the divine and a reminder of humanity's relationship to the natural world are both depicted in the biblical account of the Garden of Eden, which, in the end, has symbolic and spiritual importance for those who believe in its existence. It is possible that its actual location will, despite the fact that it is exciting to explore, always remain a matter of faith, individual interpretation, and imaginative speculation. Genesis belief. The belief in the Garden of Eden, as portrayed in the book of Genesis, has a great deal of weight within Judeo-Christian traditions and has been a significant factor in the development of theological and philosophical thought for many centuries. According to the story that is told in the Bible, the Garden of Eden is portrayed as a paradise. It is described as a place that is untainted and abundant, and it was there that Adam and Eve, the first human beings, lived in harmony with nature and in direct communication with God. The book of Genesis paints a picture of the Garden of Eden as a verdant and picture-perfect landscape, full of an assortment of trees, fruits, and animals of all kinds. It is described as a realm that is free from misery, agony, and death, and is a haven of perfect harmony and innocence. It is reported that four rivers, the Pishon, the Gihon, the Tigris, and the Euphrates, were responsible for watering the garden. Adam, the first human, and Eve, who was made from one of Adam's ribs, were both created by God in the Garden of Eden. Adam was the first human. They were placed in the garden with the duty of caring for it, and they were granted authority over all of the other creatures that lived there. When Adam and Eve are confronted by a serpent with the proposition to eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, which God specifically forbade them to do, the plot takes an important turn. They gave in to the temptation and ate the fruit that was specifically forbidden to them. As a result of this transgression, they were kicked out of the Garden of Eden. It is widely held that this occurrence, which is frequently referred to as fall of man, was the cause of the introduction of sin, suffering, and the separation of humanity from its initial state of perfection. Within the framework of Judeo-Christian theology, the concept of the Garden of Eden serves as an essential component in the comprehension of human origins, the character of sin, and the urgent requirement for redemption. It poses significant concerns regarding the connection that exists between human beings, the natural world, and the divine. The account of Adam and Eve's time in the Garden of Eden has been interpreted in a variety of ways by many religious and theological traditions. The event is interpreted literally by some as a literal historical occurrence, while others regard it symbolically as symbolizing universal themes of human experience and the repercussions of moral decisions. The story of the Garden of Eden continues to provoke thought and introspection on a wide range of subjects, including human purity, the dynamics of temptation, and the yearning for a paradise that was lost. It has also spurred conversations on the inherent contradiction between humanity's quest for knowledge and the constraints set by divine precepts. These discussions have been sparked as a result of this event. New hypothesis. A new theory has been developed in order to account for a discovery that has been made in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. Jody Magnus, an archaeologist, is the one who first offered this theory. She was led to it as a result of a discovery that she made in a church in Jerusalem to have faith that she is the solution to the enigma. It is commonly held that Jesus of Nazareth was executed and then raised to life at what is now known as the cross, sometimes called Calvary or Golgotha. The Church of the Holy Sepulchre, located in the old city of Jerusalem, is of the opinion that Adam was destined to stay put in the same spot for the night. Jesus is, it is thought, that was crucified on the cross rock of Golgotha, which is the large one in the middle of the granite outcrop found in the middle of the neighborhood of Jerusalem known as Golgotha. She indicated that the hint was derived from 2017. The rocky was placed beneath the rock of Golgotha's rocky outcrop where Christians base their faith. The cross upon which Jesus was crucified is known as the Adam Chapel, which, if one is to believe the Christian tradition that has been upheld with Adam, the first man, this is identified with him. Tale may be traced all the way back to the earliest days of Christianity that are supposedly mentioned in legend during the time that Jesus was being crucified on the rock above us. His blood seeped from the hole in the ceiling chink in the rock's armor. Adam, the first man, is described as buried beneath the ground, but when Jesus' body was buried, blood dripped onto him and he was covered in it. Adam, the first man, was laid to rest after his resurrection, buried beneath the surface, in contrast to the description of something that is found in the Bible. Conclusion. The mythical Garden of Eden is embedded in numerous religious and cultural stories. The quest to discover its actual location and form continues to excite the curious. Its symbolic potency as a reflection of the universal yearning for lost paradise, a state of perfect harmony and spiritual connection with the natural world, is more important than its actual location. If you enjoyed this, please subscribe to our channel and join us again soon.